Hey everyone, Tim Beery here with a look at how you can expand your musical palette simply by doing the things you already do in a different way. Here we go. Like so many of you, I don't get a chance to sit at the kit and practice every day. But I am always working stuff out in my head. A lick, a fill, a groove will pop into my mind as I'm going through the day. And I visualize how I would apply it to the kit, how it would feel to play it, where I might use it in a given situation, just as I'm going through my everyday stuff. Then when I sit down at the kit to practice, I've got something new to do, even if it's something I've played a million times before. It might be a different way of looking at something I've played a million times before. And that's what this is about. How you can take something you've played before, twist it around, do it in different ways so it becomes something new, so you're not practicing the same old stuff and getting stale. So, the other day this popped into my mind. Pattern I've played many times before, groove. In fills, I think I lifted it from Billy Cobham all those years ago. This is how you would play it. And a little faster. So when I sat down at the kit, I thought, okay, how can I do that and make it feel more effortless? Because to me, I want everything I do to be effortless, even if it's the most complicated stuff I play. If it feels effortless, that comes across in the music to me and makes the music feel better. So the first thing that popped into my mind was, well, I can add a double to it. Maybe I can do that triplet pattern using a double instead of, try that. As opposed to, oh, wait a minute. This double thing doesn't alternate. And I'm real big on alternating. Feels good though. So how could I do that and yet alternate it? And the thing that came to my mind was my old friend, the paradiddle. Ah, so you take a paradiddle, add a double to the beginning. And you get this. Now that feels pretty good. Feels a little bit more effortless. Yeah, there's a lot of arm movement going around with those single strokes. And so from that first thought, I come upon this, which is something I've never played before. And then that takes me down an entirely new rabbit hole of, well, how can I apply that concept, that adding two strokes to the beginning of a paradiddle, to other rudiments, to other things I've already played. And the first thing, obvious thing that comes to mind is the double paradiddle. That's pretty cool, as opposed to single strokes. Now, granted, it takes a little bit of work to get the double powerful and sounding like it's actually a single stroke, but you can do it and it will come pretty quickly. So now I have two exercises. All from one little thing. So the point of this is to look inside what you already do. Think of different ways to stick it. Think of different ways to apply it to the kit. You don't have to know a million licks. You only have to know three or four or five that you can play a million different ways. It's the same concept. I'll see you soon.